Elliot Harrison, and this is Madeline Harrison.
Not one, but two. Twins born on what Mom calls the coolest day of the year, and they were all about numero uno.
Well, these were born on 11-11 around 1 o'clock, so there's another one, and they're just as cute can be. The twins are a boy and a girl, I mean, it's a perfect match.
Morgan Clifford from Wisconsin is celebrating her 11th birthday. It's a real once-in-a-lifetime kind of day. She's celebrating this ultimate golden birthday in New York City.
There's a lot going on, and there's a lot of stuff to do. So I just wanted to explore.
She's celebrating with the Rockettes and doing different things like that, so I would say it's pretty amazing.
Morgan's got a to-do list of 11 things, including walking 11 blocks down 11th Avenue, eating at 11 restaurants, and meeting at least 11 New Yorkers on her birthday.
Has anyone unusual sung happy birthday to you? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday. Will 11-11 be the luckiest day of a lifetime? Not the least until next December, when the calendar will read 12-12. And you bring me 10-7 out of the stairs.
That's cute. Well, some gamble is hoping to cash in on today's lucky day to so many people play the numbers. In the pick four game, that the state lottery stopped issuing the numbers for today's midday and evening draw.
Wow, stop. Ohio. I would take this. Stop.
Someone unusual. So you have a
yeah, that's so cute.
It's unusual.
Yeah, she is. And unusually colder temperatures. Well, not unusual, actually, it is November.
But that's, yeah. And that's what you can get, you know, tricked into.
Yeah,
it's just been amazing. Well, yeah, so it's a little back to reality, but not for a long period of time, just for tonight into tomorrow morning, when the mild temperatures start to come back over the weekend. Let's go outside tonight, where now skies are clearing out, and there are folks right outside our studios on Columbus Avenue and 66th Street. And there are folks in heavier coats tonight. The wind is gusting about 25 to 30 miles per hour. And tonight's that first night in a while where you need the scarf, the gloves, and the heavy coat. And, you know, maybe you step outside and say it's not so bad in the first 5 minutes, but if you're staying out for a long period of time tonight, you want the heavy coat. It will feel chilly. Later on, you can see leaves in the trees still rustling in the wind. But there are still leaves on the trees in New York City right now. A great color in Central Park this weekend. 46% humidity and a temperature to match at 46 degrees. Again, the wind gusting to near 30 miles an hour, the pressure on the rise, and the high today only 47. That's after going near low mid-60s yesterday. The average high is 56, so below normal for a change. What a switch. And there are your sunrise and sunset times. Last year in the state, 56, and a lot of sunshine. Headlines. Well, it's a normal November night for a change. Wind chills actually go down to 25 to 35. But then we have that rapid recovery. I think we're 60 by Sunday, and even a little bit better. Next week will begin mild. A little different than the recent mild stretch. I think we're in and out of clouds and the occasional shower, but it's still going to be mild. Now tonight, rain and snow showers will continue over parts of the Hudson Valley and into the Catskills, a couple of flurries here. That'll happen for the next few hours, but now that the sun has set, they'll diminish pretty quickly. That's because of this cold pool of air over Ontario and Quebec, and also this enhanced stripe of cloudiness could be over the northern suburbs when you wake up tomorrow morning. If you're an early riser, you see a patchy cloud, don't worry about it. We're going mostly sunny. And then the temperatures will start to recover. Now we're 21 degrees colder than we were at this time yesterday, but if you look about 500-600 miles to our west, the recovery is already beginning, and it's warmer than it was at this time yesterday. And I think we'll start to warm up nicely tomorrow afternoon, getting into the mid-50s with the help of more of a west-southwest wind than the colder west and northwest wind that we've had all day long. By Sunday, even warmer, 62 degrees, and we're already above average again. This front will continue to bring more clouds in early next week, but we'll still be in the mid-60s, and with enough sun on Monday, parts of New Jersey can actually get close to 70 degrees. Here's your accurate weather forecast. So it is rather blustery this evening, and then it's clearing and cold. The wind chills again mid-20s to mid-30s. Lower the city actually had to take down a little bit because we're dropping so fast. We're in the upper 30s. 56 after a cold morning. The afternoon feels pretty nice. Mostly sunny right where we should be. And then tomorrow night, not as cold. A little less windy. You're going to notice the breeze pretty much all weekend long. We're at 46. Blogger Bus is already posted. 7 online on your iPad, web, smartphone, when we're not here.
So it won't be that bad.
No, not at all. Just tonight and tomorrow. We'll chill. Okay. That's so bad.
Adam Sandler on the big screen twice at the same time, but is it twice as much fun? Sandy's review is coming up next.
Also, another injury on the Broadway set of Spider-Man. We'll have more on the accident that had an actor rushed to the hospital.
It's smoked barbecue brisket braised in tequila and oregano, and it's on the menu at Mexi-Q Kitchen and Grab. I'm Lauren Glassberg, and Neighborhood Inches coming up.
Another day, another school named in the SAT cheating scandal here in Long Island. We'll have all the details and reaction coming up in a live report.
This is an Eyewitness News commuter alert.
I'm Heather O'Rourke in the traffic center. Let's take a look at our mass transit systems for your commuter. Long Island Railroad, Metro North, New Jersey Transit, they're running on a posted schedule. As far as the subways are concerned, C&E trains are still running express only. Penn Station down to Canal Street. We'll look at the Hudson River Crossings chart. Your delays for your commuter going outbound to George Washington Bridge. Heavy from all approaches, about 10 to get across the span. Outbound Lincoln, an hour and a half. The outbound Holland, that is up to an hour delay. And we'll look at a west gap. Take a look at the New England Thruway right here at Tremont Avenue. Delays for your commuter begin at Connor Street, and then they go on to the crossroads. Disabled tractor trailer at Rosedale Avenue. An accident at the Sheridan, and you stay slow to George Washington Bridge. Eyewitness News at 5. We'll be right back.
Outro tours on Tampa this Sunday. A former city cop fights to get his job back, and a week-long celebration of Latin music, dancing, and more on Tampa Sunday morning at 11:30.
Tonight, after police officers got caught in their own trap, what made these servers say this to Chris Cuomo?
Thanks, Chris.
These pictures really are worth a thousand words. Caught in the Act. Special Hours of 2020 starts at 9 after Extreme Makeover Home Edition on ABC.
It's Kohl's Veterans Day sale with over 152-day specials. Love to give toys at 10 to 40% off. Happy to save an extra 20% on all of them, like game tins starting at $6.99. Love to give kitchen electrics like a baby cake street maker for $24.99. Love to give warmth. Happy to save 50 to 60% on outerwear. Plus, earn $10 Kohl's cash for every 50 you spend, no limits. Get to Kohl's Veterans Day sale this Friday and Saturday for the gifts you love to give.